Welcome to Wings of Aero, Advanced Education and Research Organization. To know more, visit our official webpage www.wingsofaero.in. Today, I will show you tricks about velocity triangle of an axial flow compressor. It is a very important topic. Let's focus on it. First, let me give an intro about axial compressor. It is a compressor which allows or continues to pressurize the gases by continuous rotating the airfoil based blades, which works on a principle of flowing parallel to axis of rotation or axially. It consists of rotating and stationary components, which is the rotating components is called as a rotor and the stationary component is known as a stator. This has a basic three applications: industrial, aerospace and research. And you can see it is displayed, the table is displayed in your screen, that how, what is the efficiency per stage. First of a rotor, which allows or direct the air to flow correct direction, that's what it known as a inlet guide vane, which is guiding. Here comes a velocity triangle of an axial flow axial flow compressor. Here you can see this is a IGV, this IGV here, IGV, then we have a rotor blade, then we have a stator blade. So what happens, the air or the fluid is coming here. From here it is from the inlet guide vane, it is leaving from the IGV. The exit of a inlet guide vane will be equal to the entry velocity of a triangle. Then from the exit velocity triangle of a rotor blade will be the entry of a stator, and this is the exit of a stator, exit fluid of a stator. Now here the entry velocity triangle of a rotor denoted by the region 1, the exit velocity triangle of a rotor denoted by the letter 2 or region 2, and the again the exit velocity triangle for stator denoted by the region 3. So in this diagram you can see that you can see the velocity triangle. Now I will describe about the nomenclature or introduce about the nomenclature of the velocity triangle. Now first we have a U is a tangential blade speed or blade velocity. This is called as a, this is U. For axial compressor, here the blade speed remains constant in all the stages, in all the stages. Now what is C is the absolute flow velocity, and W is a relative flow velocity. Now what is CT1? CT1 is a tangential component of axial flow. And what is WT? Is a tangential flow or tangential component of a relative flow velocity. What is CA? CA is a connecting or common line in between the absolute and the relative flow. CA is known as an axial component of an absolute flow velocity. Now what is beta? Beta, this side is a region for the relative and this side is a region for absolute. So what is beta? Beta actually is the angle subtended. What angle is that? It is a relative flow angle, or we can say relative flow air angle. Whereas beta is a side of absolute. So we can A for absolute or alpha B A, you can likewise you can remember that is absolute flow air velocity. Similarly for the second region, same things follows. Now how you can remember this sequence? I have one more tricks. You can remember WBAC or W for the relative, which is sign like W. I is a B instead of beta, A for alpha, and C is a absolute velocity. Likewise you can remember, that is it is coming in a series way, W, beta, alpha, C. Right. Now I will explain a detailed explanation or the formulation of this velocity triangle, because if you refer further previous year question, you have to well known about this velocity triangle to solve a problem. So I will derive and a very easy way how you can memorize it in just few steps. So first you can see the diagram here. So here we have a blade speed u, and what is u? U is a summation of this relative tangential component of a relative velocity and the tangential component of an absolute velocity. So it is that. Now we have to bring an expression which is a common for both the terms. Now what is a common for both the terms? That is CA. What is CA? Axial component of an absolute flow velocity. That is a common terms. Now we have to bring this terms in terms of CA1. Why CA1? Because this is a region 1. This triangle, consider this a triangle, this is a common terms. Now consider this triangle. What happens? This is a height and this is a base, tan alpha. So what is the height? CT1. And what is the base? CA1. We get it. And just rearranging the equation, we get a CT1 equals to CA1 into tan alpha 1. Now similarly, we will go for this triangle, this triangular element. So what we'll do, we will find this tan beta 1 equals to height by base. See this? Height by base. Now rearranging, what we can get, WT1 equals to CA1 tan beta 1. Now this we found WT1 and CT1, we are going to apply in this formula, we get this. Now by simplifying, what are the common terms? CA1 and here also CA1. Take the CA1 common and you get this tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 1. Similar way, you will find for this region 2 or the exit velocity triangle of a rotor blade. So you got this u equals to CT2 plus WT2 here. Now what is a common here? Here also same CA2. So you get this triangle and you get this. Then rearranging, you get CT2 equals to CA2 tan alpha 2. Then further take the other triangle, this one triangle, take this triangle. What happens? This triangle, you get this. And from there you can obtain WT2 equals to CA2 tan beta 2. Now you have this and this, substitute in this equation and what you get? You get this value. Now what are the common terms? Take the common inside and you get this. Now finally we have this two equation. So see in the right, left hand side you have u. So can we equate it? So let's equate this two equation. If you equate this two equation, you get CA1 tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 1 equals to A2 tan alpha 2 plus tan beta 2. Now consider this axial flow velocity is constant throughout the system or throughout the stage. So we can, that time we can write as CA equals to CA1 equals to CA2 equals to CA3. Now apply this value in the previous equation. You get tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 2 equals to tan alpha 2 plus tan beta 2. Now from here you can get two more equations related to that. That is tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2 equals to tan beta 2 minus tan beta 1. Or tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1 equals to tan beta 1 minus tan beta 2. You can get any two of this. You might have a confusion about this alpha beta. Remember, the region 1 will be one side equals to the region 2. What do you mean by region 1? Region 1 is an entry velocity triangle of a rotor blade. What we have here? We have both alpha and beta. So tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 1 equals to tan alpha 2 plus tan beta 2. If you know this form, and then it will be easy for you to find this too. This is an important part. Then second important thing is flow coefficient, which is denoted by the term phi and is a ratio between the axial flow and the blade speed. Now, how you can remember this flow coefficient? See this diagram. First, here we have a CA1, just this line, and then we have a U. Remember this diagram. And if you put 5 over here, you can assume this is a flow coefficient. First, we have CA by U. So, it is comes in a correct sequence. And the reciprocal of this flow coefficient can be written as tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 2 or tan alpha 2 plus tan beta 2. Here, these are the important formation. Then comes work done. Work done equals to U by CT2 minus CT1. You might have a confusion that which one come first. So remember this, W equals to U 2 minus 1. This is a GATE 2018 question which I have solved and which is also available in my channel. You can go down and the link is in the description box. So this is a figure. In some other author book you can find that they are also mentioning that absolute velocity in terms of V1 and the relative velocity is VR1 and the axial velocity denoted by VF. So this is nothing, don't get confused. This is another way of noting this velocity triangle. You can follow any one of the notation. This is a very important part. This is a very, very important and conceptual part. So how they are varying occurs across the stator and the rotor. So first, for that, you need to remember this diagram. So this is a rotor end, exit of a rotor end. This is a stator and this is a again exit of a stator end. So what happens here? See, in the stator, exit of the stator, we don't have any relative velocity. Here at the stator, we don't have any relative velocity. Make a note of it. That's why you see here we have this chart. Remember this chart or table. We have 5 things: absolute velocity, relative velocity, static pressure, total pressure, flow width. So in place of relative velocity, see the stator, we have hyphen. Means nothing is there because it is absent. So we kept hyphen, right? Now, next comes, see here in this diagram, see the width of this? This is absolute. Absolute is high compared to the relative velocity. So in the rotor, what we can say? The absolute is high and the relative is low. Got the point? And you remember, since a compressor, it has always have a tendency to increase the pressure. Don't confuse with the total pressure and the static pressure. Both are different. The static pressure will be keep on enhancing across the stages. So in both the rotor as in both the rotor as well as stator, the static pressure will be keep on increasing. In rotor, the total pressure will be high, but in the stator, because in stator what happens? In the stator, the blades are not rotating. So what will happen? The total pressure will remain constant, right? Now, you remember this chart. First, we have absolute, relative, static pressure, total pressure, flow width. Now, only this we have in lower. Only this first two region cross we have a lower and the total pressure here we have a constant. Other than that, what we all are increasing. Likewise, you can remember, and every time they're asking one fundamental conceptual questions from this part, so please focus on this part. Thank you for watching this video. If you have further inquiry or requested video, drop down to our mail wingsofarrow@gmail.com. Don't forget to subscribe for more updates. For the time being, take care, stay blessed, inspired, and fly high.